Serana and I gained entry to the Temple of Ariel and cautiously pushed open the ancient doors.
What is that?
Inside, we found statues.
Serana.
Falmer and Charis, frozen to solid ice.
What are those? Falmer?
Surrounding the monument in the entry chamber and scattered throughout the side rooms of the temple.
They are frozen. Why are they all frozen? Oh, this is very strange. Who froze them? Did Gellibor and the other paladins freeze them when they attacked?
They're frozen. Ice.
Aye.
I wonder how long they've been like this.
Aye, that's...
And I thought the soul care was creepy.
Well, agree. This is pretty creepy. Not sure it's worse than that, but... Wow. Yeah, I wonder how long it's been like this. Let's keep exploring. Skeletons? I wonder who they were. Look, some of these Falmer are holding things. A spell tome? Just as ugly as ice statues as they are in real life. Ooh, chest.
Oh.
Excuse me? I bet this was beautiful once. Who do you think these skeletons are? More statues. Look, it's a Charis too. I don't think they can be that old because they look like the Falmer as they look now. Not the way Gellibor looked. What is back here? This temple wall is busted down. Look, I think this goes back inside.
Through a caved-in wall, we followed a snow-covered passage into the main chapel, where we found even more statues, and the arch-curate Werther, Gellibor's brother.
All right, Serana. It looks like the only way forward is to jump. I don't know how we will get back up, but... Well, we just have to trust we'll find a way. Let's go. Ah, that is a throne, and someone is sitting on it. I think that must be Werther. What do you think?
He was seated upon a frozen throne, protected behind several rows of jagged ice shards thrusting up from the ground.
Did you really come here expecting to claim Ariel's bow? You've done exactly as I predicted and brought your fetching companion to me.
Wait, is he talking about me?
Which, I'm sorry to say, means your usefulness is at an end!
Werther was not at all pleased to see us. and he somehow set the figures of ice within the chamber to attack.
The statues are coming alive! Don't you die, nasty Charis. Not the polymer, too! What are they? Are they vampires? Look at the blood on their faces, Serana.
An impressive display, but a wasted effort. You delay nothing but your own deaths.
Watch out! He's talks a lot.
We defeated wave after wave of them until finally,
Verthar
simply began to collapse the entire room upon us.
I think they are vampires, sir. Look at them. See the one with the wings? They don't look normal.
This has gone on long enough.
Better get down here.
Once he saw we were not so easily defeated, he exploded the chapel completely in an awesome display of magical power.
Come on, we can do this. I know we can. He's up there on the balcony. Oh. Come on.
Damn it.
I was knocked to the ground.
Head.
But Serana helped me to my feet, and we went together to chase down our enemy.
Where is he, Serana?
As we approached Gellibor's brother on a balcony overlooking the Vale,
there he is.
We learned the real truth behind Werther's betrayal.
I was the arch-curate of Ariel, girl. I had the ears of a god.
Until the betrayed corrupted you. Yes, yes, we've heard this sad story.
Gellibor and his kind are easily manipulated fools. Look into my eyes, Serana. You tell me what I am.
You're a vampire? But Ariel should have protected you.
The moment I was infected by one of my own initiates, Ariel turned his back on me.
He turned all those farmers.
I swore I'd have my revenge, no matter what the cost.
You want to take revenge on a god?
Ariel himself may have been beyond my reach, but his influence on our world wasn't. All I needed was the blood of a vampire and his own weapon, Ariel's bow.
The blood of a vampire, Ariel's bow. It was you? You created that prophecy?
A prophecy that lacked a single final ingredient, the blood of a pure vampire. The blood of a daughter of Cold Harbor.
You're waiting all this time for someone with my blood to come along. Well, too bad for you. I intend on keeping it. Let's see if your blood has any power to it.
It was not the Falmer who had turned him. He was a vampire.
Kill him, Serana. We must put an end to this. Let the sun shine bright in the sky, Verthar. Damn you and your prophecy. You are a fool.
He claimed that after one of his own initiates had infected him, Ariel had turned his back on the Arch-Curate.
Is it really done?
And so Verthar plotted the ultimate revenge.
Is he dead?
To blot out Ariel's gift to our world, the sun itself.
At the end, Serana?
Verthar was the one who had devised the tyranny of the sun and set the entire prophecy in motion.
Finally, Serana. It's over.
We battled the snow elf vampire there on the balcony, and he was defeated.
The prophecy is done. Well, he has some ancient armor. Would you like to have this? I don't think it's quite my style. I wonder. I suppose we should take it. We won't have another opportunity, will we?
Upon Werther's death, Gellibor was able to once again use the Way Shrine at the temple.
The Way Shrine opened.
He met us almost immediately at the bottom of the balcony.
Let's go see if Gellibor
I explained the
here.
Entire situation to him, and after thanking us for restoring the chantry, he handed over Ariel's bow to me.
Gellibor, did this Way Shrine open to the one in Darkfall Cave? It's good to see you, but we have, well, news.
So the deed has been done.
Aye.
The restoration of this Way Shrine means that Werther must be dead, and the Betrayed no longer have control over him.
Aye, but listen, Gellibor. The story is not quite what you think. The Betrayed were not to blame.
What? What are you talking about?
Your brother. Werther was... Well, he was a vampire, Gellibor. He controlled those Betrayed. He must have forced them to attack you.
A vampire? I see. That would explain much. Deep inside, it brings me joy that the Betrayed weren't to blame for what happened here.
Why is that? They were still accomplices.
Because that means there's still hope that they might one day shed their hatred and learn to believe in Auriel once again. It's been a long time since I felt that way, and it's been long overdue. My thanks to both of you.
Well, that is a noble thought, Gellibor. And you are welcome. We are glad to put an end to that prophecy.
You risked everything to get Auriel's bow. And in turn, you've restored the chantry. I can't think of a more deserving champion to carry it than you. If you wish to learn more about the bow, or obtain Sunhallowed arrows for it, I'd be more than happy to help. You've but to ask.
Thank you, Gellibor. Ooh.
Please, take the bow. It's yours.
Wow. That is impressive. I'm almost afraid to touch it. But only almost.
It's not as shiny as I was expecting. Still, it's beautiful.
Well, it was pretty shiny before I picked it up. All right, Serana, we have the bow. What do we do now?
I think we both know. It's time to face my father. If we don't, he'll keep chasing us for the rest of our lives.
Aye. But you know that if we go after him, he will have to die.
I've been thinking about this for a long time. It's not easy. But I don't think we have much of a choice. No, this has to end here and now.
All right. Let's face him together, then. I am with you, Serana.
If we head back to the castle and kick the front door in, we're gonna be knee-deep in his friends. Let's head back to Ysran and let him see what we've got first. I'm betting he'll lend us a sword or two.
Ha! Great. Hopefully this will convince Ysran.
It's so bright out here. I don't know how you stand it.
Well, I know, yes. Listen, Werther said some strange things about vampire blood and the bow. Can you tell me more about that?
Do you know? Do you know what he was talking about?
It sounds like that's the last bit of the prophecy. The blood of a daughter of Cold Harbor can corrupt the bow.
Right. And you are a daughter of Cold Harbor, which is why you have this part in the prophecy.
So I am. I guess we could use my blood. Do you have any arrows? Elven arrows? I'm not going to just bleed on any old thing.
No, Serana, I did not mean I wanted your blood.
Oh, all right then.
You may keep all of your blood, Serana. Okay, are we ready to do this thing?
I don't think you can ever be ready to kill your parent. I'm doing my best to not think of him as my father anymore.
I know this is hard. Let me know if I can help, okay? If you need anything, just want to talk, whatever.
We've got enough to worry about right now. You stay focused, and I'll worry about me.
All right. Look, let's talk to Gellibor about this bow a little bit more, too, before we go.
If there's assistance I can provide, just ask. It's the least I can do. I trust you're faring well.
Aye, Gellibor. We are well. So, we have the bow now, Gellibor. What else can you tell me about the bow, eh?
The bow was said to be carried by Auriel himself into battle against the forces of Lorkhan in ancient and mythic times. Its craftsmanship has no equal anywhere within Tamriel, and possibly beyond.
It seems like a powerful artifact. What can it do?
The bow draws its power from Aetherius itself, channeling it through the sun. Therefore, when an arrow is loosed from the bow, it produces a magical effect very similar to being burned by fire.
Oh, well, that does indeed sound powerful.
That's actually only a fraction of its potential.
Really?
With sun-hallowed arrows, you would be able to produce a much more spectacular effect, causing bursts of sunlight to envelop your foes. The sunbursts would certainly hurt anything, but is especially devastating to the undead.
Right. Listen, your brother said something about using blood on the bow. What is that all about?
Well, using an arrow with the bow that's been dipped in blood may cause it to function differently, corrupting its purpose. That's, of course, if you're foolish enough to try it.
No. It's too beautiful to corrupt. These sun-hallowed arrows you mentioned, how do I obtain them?
I can actually assist you in that regard.
Oh, great.
If you were to bring me some good quality elven arrows, I could imbue them with the proper incantations and rituals.
Actually, I have some right here. Can you make me some sun-hallowed arrows, please?
Certainly. I can only do 20 at a time, but I see that won't be a problem in this case.
Thank you, Gellibor. Yeah, I don't have many, but I want to try them out. What will happen to the chantry now that we have it, opened back up again? Now that, Verthar is gone, and you can travel here, would you try to rebuild? It is a beautiful temple.
While it would fill me with joy to see the chantry back to its former glory, that time has long since passed. Now that my brother's dead, it's quite possible I'm the last of our kind.
Yes. That is sobering. I suppose we contributed to the extinction of your kind, then. I am sorry for that.
There's no need for that kind of talk. I said it was possible. It's also quite possible that there are some other isolated conclaves of snow elves nestled elsewhere on Nern. I'll also assume Vertha didn't exactly give you the option to stay your hand.
No, certainly not. And what about you? What are you going to do now, Gellibor?
For the time being, I would remain here, on the Overlook, and continue trying to keep the Sanctum free of the Betrayed. You're always welcome to return here at any time, of course.
Thank you. What do you think about the Betrayed, now that you know that they did not turn your brother? Do you think they can be cured?
I feel nothing but sympathy for the Betrayed, despite my actions against them. But I'm afraid that they're well beyond a cure at this point.
Really? Why is that?
The twisted forms you've seen didn't occur overnight. It isn't a plague or a disease that ravaged our species. The dwarves may have stolen their sight, but it took many generations for them to become what they are today.
Right. So I suppose there is no hope for them, eh?
Perhaps they'll never return to their former appearance. But over the centuries, I've noticed a rise in their intellect. If a line of communication could be established with them, maybe they can find peace. It's the only way they'll discover that they weren't always malignant. They were once a proud and prosperous race.
Right, well, I wish you well, Gellibor. Good luck. And,
You're always welcome to return here at any time, of course.
Aye, thank you. I appreciate that. We must...
If there's assistance I can provide, just ask. It's the least I can do.
Aye, thank you. I'm afraid now we have a bigger task. We must go and defeat Harkon.
With the hallowed weapon in hand, it was time to put the prophecy to rest.
Oh, come on, Serana.
Serana was ready, though I tried as gently as I could to tell her that we really had no choice but to kill her father.
Beautiful place.
She grudgingly agreed and said she had known it would come to that.
Such beauty and ugliness.
At her suggestion, we decided to head back to Izran to see if the Dawnguard was prepared to help.
Mixed together in the same place.
Harkon and the other vampires at Castle Vorkehar were certainly not going to go down easily.